हेलो हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम। आई एम एम कुतवाल, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ एग्रोनॉमी, सदगुरु कॉलेज ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर, मिरजगांव। टुडे वी डिस्कस आवर कोर्स एग्रो 2-3-4, क्रॉप प्रोडक्शन टेक्नोलॉजी फर्स्ट इन दैट खरीफ क्रॉप्स। टुडे वी डिस्कस द डिफरेंट ऑयल सीड क्रॉप्स एंड पल्सिस क्रॉप्स। The most important pulses crops in that pigeon pea, we called as a tur, mung bean, udit bean, cow pea, kidney bean, and horse gram. These are the most important pulses crops. These pulses crops, first pigeon pea or tur, botanically known as Kajanus kajan, black gram, udit, botanically known as Vigna mungo, green gram, moog, Vigna radiata, kidney bean, Phaseolus acantifolia or mutki, and cowpea, it's Sauli, the Vigna senescens. These are the five important kharif pulses crops. This Indian Institute for the Pulses Researcher, Research Institute at the Kanpur, Uttar Pradesh. There will be research on the all pulses crops. Today we discuss most important or second important pulse crops after the chickpea. This is the pigeon pea, or we called as a red gram or tur, botanically we known as the Kajanus kajan, family Fabaceae, or we called as a leguminaceae family. Pigeon pea originated from Africa. Area and distribution for the pigeon pea crop. Red gram or pigeon pea grown over the area 3.5 million hectare and production of 2.8 million tons. Important tur growing state in our India: Maharashtra, Uttar Pradesh, Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu and Gujarat. These are the six important states for the maximum production of the pigeon pea. Then all over the world, the Africa, West Indies, Australia, Malaya, these are the some important pigeon pea growing countries. Economic importance. Pigeon pea is commonly known as red gram or arar. After the chickpea, it is the second most important pulse crops in our country. It accounts for about 11.8% of the total pulse area and 17% of the total pulse production of the country. It is a rich source of protein. It is mainly eaten the form of dal. It is a legume crop. It fix the abundant quantity of the atmospheric nitrogen in soil through the root nodules. It is also a rich source of iron, iodine and essential amino acids like lysine, tyrosine, cysteine and arginine. So this is the economical importance of our pigeon pea crop. Then we discuss about the soil and climatic requirement of pigeon pea crops. Sandy loam, heavy black type soil can be useful for the production of the pigeon pea. pH range ranging 6.5 to 7.5, it is the normal pH soil and type of soil it can be required for the pigeon pea growing. Saline, alkaline and waterlogged soil are unfit for the pigeon pea growing cultivation. So this is the very important part, the waterlogged soil is help for the pigeon pea production. Then we discuss about the climatic requirement for the pigeon pea crop. Warm tropical, subtropical climate, it is a favorable its growth and development of tur crop. The optimum temperature required for tur crop is 18 to 26 degrees Celsius. This is the optimum temperature. During flowering and ripening stage, it requires bright sunshine hours. Highly susceptible to frost at the time of the flowering. This is crop sensitive for the frosty condition at the time of the flowering, and bright sunshine hours required at the time of the flowering and ripening. So these are the very important climatic phenomena are affect on the crop and development of the tur crop. Rainfall requirement, annual average rainfall is required 60 to 70 centimeter, means near about 600 to 700 millimeter rainfall is required for its better growth and development. Then we discuss about the preparatory tillage or pre-tillage of red gram crop. Red gram crop requires well-tilled and well-drained seed bed, one summer ploughing, and 2 to 3 crosswise harrowing should be required. And at the time of last harrowing, we should apply 10 to 15 tons of FOM. Or then seeds and sowing. After the preparatory tillage, we discuss about the seeds and sowing. Seed treatment. Seed treats with the carbendazim or bavistin or thrium at the rate 3 grams per kg of the seeds. The spacing should be kept for the red gram for the different according to type of the varieties. Early varieties, mid-late varieties and late varieties can be manage the spacing. For the early varieties, 45 centimeter between the two rows and 10 centimeter between to the plants, spacing 40 by 10 centimeter for the early varieties. Generally, early varieties complete its life cycle within 120 days. Mid-late varieties, it required 60 centimeter between two rows and 20 centimeter spacing between two plants should be kept, and its life cycle crop duration period is 140 to 160 days. Then late maturity varieties, it requires wider spacing, kept 90 centimeter or 3 feet into 15 to 20 centimeter between two plants, and this late varieties, they will be complete its life cycle within 180 to 190 days. This is the longer lifespan of this late varieties. Then we discuss about the sowing methods. Generally, pigeon pea sow with the seed drill, seed cum fertilizer drill, or automatic multiple seed drills, or dibbling method also useful for the sowing of red gram. Then seed rate, sowing time and season. So drilling soil crop required 12 to 15 kg seeds per hectare. For the intercropping system, 6 to 9 kg of seed of pigeon pea per hectare required. Then sowing time and season. Generally, pigeon pea sown in the kharif season, and sowing time is on early onset of monsoon, means June to July. This is the sowing time of the pigeon pea crop. Then intercultivation, intercultivation in that most important part, in that weed management, water management. So intercultivation, hoeing and hand weeding should be done. The two mechanical weedings, one at 25 to 30 days after sowing, and second hand weeding 40 to 45 days after the sowing. Then field of the pigeon pea get higher yield, kept the weed free up to the 30 to 45 days. This is the 30 to 45 days. Firstly, this period are crop weed competition period, so we should keep this field weed free from the weeds. We can use also pre-emergence herbicides like Alaclor or Lasso at the rate 3 liter per hectare should be applied for the weed control. And also another one herbicide can be used, Fluchlorelin, we called as a Basalin, 1 kg active ingredient per hectare in 800 to 1000 liter of water as per the planting spray can be applied for the weed control. Then we discuss about the fertilizer management. Manures and fertilizers, we should apply 15 to 20 cartloads FYM at the last harrowing. When we preparatory tillage operation carried out, that time we will be apply the farmyard manure and compost. Then after that we can apply the 25 kg nitrogen and 50 kg of phosphorus and 0 kg potash per hectare applied at the time of the sowing. 25, 50, 0, this is the recommended fertilizer dose for pigeon pea crop. Then we discuss about the irrigation and water management. Pigeon pea is deep rooted and rain fed crops, it does not require irrigation. But when in case the prolonged dry spell during the monsoon period, supplemented irrigation provided at the vegetative growth stage, means vegetative growth stage is occur in 30 to 35 days after the sowing. And flowering stage, it is the one of the important critical growth stages for the pigeon in pigeon pea crop. It flowering stage occur in 50 to the 70 days period. And third one critical growth stage is the pod filling stage. We can apply one more irrigation when we irrigation facility available, can apply the at the pod filling stages. Flowering stage and pod filling stage are the critical growth stages of the pigeon pea crops. Harvesting and yield. Rain fed crops are harvested, the crops when the 2 to 3 or 3/4 pods are over or mature, the harvested plants should be left in the sun drying. Then threshing should be done by the beating of the pods with the sticks or mechanical threshers. Thrusher and clean grains should be sun dried to bring the moisture level 10 to 12% for the safe storage. The moisture level, it is the very essential. Low moisture level, 10 to 12% moisture should be kept at the storage grains because of the pulse beetles are attack on that. The higher moisture level it will be observed, so it will be more helpful for at the storage time. So we have to well sun drying grains should be kept on the storage. So yield of the pigeon pea crops, in that rain fed crops gives 10 to 12 quintal per hectare, and irrigated crops give 20 to 25 quintals per hectare grains can be obtained. The mixed crops system can be production near about 3 to 4 quintal of grain production per hectare. Then some important varieties of pigeon pea crops. Early varieties Bidian 265, Bidian 2, these are the early varieties. Mid-late varieties Bidian 736, BSMR 853, late varieties ICPL 87, ICPL 151, Prabhat, T. Vishakha and Vipula, these are the important varieties of the pigeon pea crops. Thank you. All about the we discussed the pigeon pea crops. Thank you.